You have to know that this man, I used to say always that this man, he knows what is here in the head. The righteous life is very important. You have to live by righteousness. Amen. Does he live or he practice a righteous life? That person sees the glory of God. He has a hope.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And those who doesn't live a righteous life, Bible makes us understand that this blessing and this hope, then they are not among. But it's a prayer that all are telling. When you come,
I say it again.
Your name is Amen.
Now,
Christ,
the
salvation that is working, waiting on us.
The mind goes to you, and you have to see.
When the second coming comes, then it seals.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what the end will be.
Then there will be no more church.
The friend is a Christian.
Something in the Greek language saying a Christian. These are those who have been selected by God.
The church,
is the people in it. And a Christian is those who have been selected. Selected them, but he sanctifies them.
Oh,
for a purpose.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look again, Ephesians chapter 5.
So if you read something from Ephesians chapter
5, verse 22 to 27,
it talks about marriage. A woman who has to live for her husband.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Lord's Excellency, if you live by the
and this tells us that we are people, or we are those who have been selected by God. So we are a priesthood.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So it refers us into Exodus chapter 19. God's purpose for the Israelite was that he's going to take them out from Egypt into a promised land.
Hallelujah.
And after preparing them, to make them priests or a royal priest, because they sanctify themselves for Christ, so that they will become a holy nation. And when we compare it into our